Welcome YouTube, Ben Born here, and welcome to another vlog. These are five things that you really need to invest in as a photographer. We all know photography is really expensive, and there are some costs in photography that you keep on incurring that cost over and over again if you don't invest really well. So before you buy a gear, you have to make sure that you really need it, and also make sure that the particular gear that you're getting will last you a long time before you have to buy them again. You wouldn't want to be buying the same thing over and over again. So when you're buying it, make sure it's once and for all and that it can last you for a long time. First thing on the list is lenses. Lenses are the most important thing, like in photography. The lens is the eye of your camera. Without your lens, you can't take a photo. You can have all the lighting gear, nice environment, nice model, but if there's no lens on your camera, there's no photo that you can take. And so you need to invest in getting lenses that are going to last you. Unfortunately, lenses are the kind of gear that like outlast everything. Lenses last everything because I'm still using the lenses that when I bought my X-T2. You know, I used X-T2 and then I moved to X-T3 and then I moved to X-T30. And it's the same lens that when I bought with the X-T2 that I'm using throughout. Camera bodies comes and go. Camera body, every year there's a new camera body. Camera body will be changing, but lenses are constant. And so by investing in your lenses, what I mean is that you need to make sure to get the right lens. Don't get a lens that you wouldn't need. If you're a portrait photographer, invest in the right lens. Get a lens that gets the job done for you. Get a lens that will make your work better or make your work easier. And again, make sure that when you buy it, it's something that you're really going to need it. And also you have to make sure that this particular lens is going to serve you for a long time. It's going to serve you all your needs for a very long time before you get to a point where you need to get another lens. Second thing on the list is light. As a strobist, lighting is really important to me. And so I make sure that I invest in the type of lights that I'm getting. Because Charlie, money no day. So when you're getting a light, you need to get a light that would serve you for a long time. The least number of lights that you should have should be two, at least one main light and one as a backup or one as a rim light. With me, I have the Godox AD600 and I have the Godox AD200 as a backup. Sometimes I use the two of them together, sometimes I use only one, and sometimes too, if I don't need more power or a lot of power, I just use the Godox AD200, which makes things easier because it's small in size and light in weight. Each of them serve their purpose, and that's something that I don't take for granted. Before buying the AD600, I made sure that like I really needed, like I needed more power on location. And the Godox AD200 too, I realized that it's not every shoot that I could use the AD600 because sometimes it's too heavy for me to use. I got the AD200 as a backup and it's serving its purpose. I wouldn't buy it for the fan of it or because it's a nice gear. No, I buy it because I need it and it's doing its job. And thankfully, light from Godox like really last if you take good care of it. Sometimes they are really delicate, but if you take good care of it, it can last you for a long time. And so don't compromise on your lighting gear and don't take it for granted. Get the ones that works for you and stick to it and take care of it and make sure that it lasts you for a long time. The third on the list is modifiers. And by modifiers, I mean umbrella, softbox, anything that you use to soften the light or use to control the light. That is a modifier. As a strobist, not only is the lighting gear important to me, the quality of light is also really important. So because of that, and when I'm buying a modifier, I'm buying a modifier that gives me the quality of light that I need. I prefer modifiers with an inner diffuser and an outer diffuser because they really give great quality of light on the skin of your subject. I don't take my modifiers for granted. Like I'm specific about the type of modifiers I use. And so I make sure I invest in it and I get the right ones for the right purposes. Fourth thing on the list is a good and fast laptop or a desktop, if that's what you like. In the current world of high quality HD 4K, if you don't have a laptop that can handle the fast from your camera, you really wouldn't enjoy photography much because the fast from our cameras now, like they are really huge. So if your laptop doesn't have the speed or the spec for you to enjoy all the benefits from your camera, it's wouldn't make sense. If you're getting a laptop or a desktop for your photography, the least RAM, the least memory RAM that you should get is 16 gig. You can buy a camera body that shoots 4K, but you can't enjoy the 4K because your laptop or your desktop can't handle the files. So you don't have to take it for granted. You need to get the right laptop that can help you be fast with, like, even editing or delivering job to clients. You need to get a laptop that's fast enough to help your work easier. A work that is going to take you an hour to do, you will need maybe 15 minutes or 30 minutes to do it. And it's about getting the work done as fast as possible. The last but not the least, and in fact, it's actually one of the most important, is yourself. You need to invest in yourself. I know, like, buying all this gear is also investing in yourself, but when I say invest in yourself, what I mean is that you need to invest in acquiring more knowledge. You need to upgrade your knowledge. You need to keep evolving and becoming the best of yourself. Don't be too comfortable or remain in the box. Keep evolving. And so in investing in yourself, what you do is that you take courses, you learn new things on YouTube. If there's a course that you need to buy, but it's expensive, you should be able to save up and get that course, because it's a knowledge that when you acquire, it's with you forever, help you to even make that money back, you know? If you're a photographer and you take only photos, you need to also look at doing videos. And in these days, like, it's easy to just switch to video. It's just by pressing an app and you're recording video. And so take courses in how to edit your own videos, how to do your own graphics and all of that. Keep evolving and learning new things every day. You need to always seek to become the possible best version of yourself each time. Knowledge is power, but sometimes you need to spend to get that knowledge. So take courses, YouTube tutorials, like a whole lot, just so you can be awesome at what you do. So these are the 5 things that I think you should invest in as a creative person or as a photographer. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.